Welcome back to Chemistry Matters. I hope you took some time to work on science and engineering practice number 3, planning and carrying out an investigation. If you got stuck or just want to compare your work to our students, you're in luck because we're going back to our classroom right now.
Okay, let's look at the investigations you've come up with. Who wants to share their plan with us?
Oh, we can.
Go ahead, Logan.
Okay. Our plan is to first visit 10 sites on the river that are each 1 kilometer apart. 6 of the sites will be in the area of the fish kill, 2 sites will be upstream, and 2 sites will be downstream.
We'll collect a 2-liter water sample at each site. Then we'll put 50 milliliters of each water sample into a different containers like cups. And of course, we'll label the cups so we remember where each sample was taken. Then we'll test the pH of each sample using the digital pH meter.
Nice work. Of course, for this investigation, it doesn't matter if you test the pH with a meter or an indicator. And by the way, this investigation is also called an experiment. So let's look at the details of how this experiment is designed. What's the testable idea of this experiment?
We're testing the hypothesis that the fish kill was caused by an acid spill into the river.
Good. And the great thing about a prediction like this is that you don't need to be correct to have a good experiment. The experiment will tell you whether you have evidence to support or reject your hypothesis. That's one of the nice things about science. It's all about finding reliable evidence. Now you need to know that every experiment has a manipulated variable, also called the independent variable. Can anyone tell me what the manipulated variable is in this experiment plan? Sam.
The only difference in each of the samples is that we're collecting them from a different location.
That's correct, good job. When you set up this experiment, you decided where you'd collect the samples. The location of the samples is the manipulated variable. Now every experiment will have at least one responding variable, also called the dependent variable. The responding variable is the variable that you're measuring as the result of your experiment. Who can identify the responding variable in this experiment? Akisha.
Since we decided to measure the acid and base level of each sample by looking at its pH level, I think the pH level is the responding variable.
Correct. The variable you're measuring is the pH of each sample. That's your responding or dependent variable. Now that you've identified the manipulated variable and the responding variable, all other factors in the experiment should be constants. So it's very important that you control all of these factors so that they're the same for all parts of the experiment. That's why constants are sometimes known as controlled variables. I'll give you an example. You decided to collect samples that are 1 kilometer away from each other. That's a constant in your experiment. Now let's see if we can identify 3 more constants.
Now come on, we're not gonna let our students give you all the answers. You're gonna have to do some of the heavy lifting on your own. Write down 3 more constants in this experiment. When you're done, discuss them with your partner. Then go to the next video in the playlist to see if you did a better job than our students.